what this individual knows to be aware of anything and to be able to warn the public. Can Whitey Bulger help solve biggest art heist in U.S. history? And then it goes to the fact that the $500 million in paintings were stolen, and they believe Whitey Bulger did it. And I just mentioned this first article to give you an idea about what a criminal this guy was. Hundreds of millions of dollars of criminal activity in the Massachusetts and surrounding areas, and all of the corruption that he was able to get away with over the years. And then, see, this is how my brain works. When I see a report like this, it makes me think about other things, like Investor's Business Daily actually telling the truth. Was Fast and Furious a gun control plot? And it goes over the U.S. government knowingly for several years under Obama's ATF, knowingly surveilling and helping get illegal guns shipped into Mexico. And then, of course, you have the head of the ATF being caught lying. We have the ATF head refusing to step down arrogantly, because they have to, as gangsters, they have to always train you that they're able to just get away with anything. That's what the gangsterish TSA is all about. It's about training you, you're little people, you're scum, you're trash, we'll do whatever we want to you. But the fact is, if we'll just call a spade, if we'll call the elephant in the room an elephant, then we can, as a society, be honest about it and do something about it. So I want to get into that report coming up. But first, I want to talk about Whitey Bulger, who finally got caught living in obscurity after disappearing for more than 15 years, being caught in California. And it's admitted, if you don't know the whole Whitey Bulger case, you can look it up, that for decades he murdered, he killed, he ordered murders. That he was untouchable. And then later it came out, after the Boston police, along with the state police, refused to go along with it anymore, that the reason he was protected was that he was a informant to the FBI. And the highest levels of the FBI knew about it and were aware of it, and that he was paying generally about 25% of all of his hundreds and hundreds of millions of profit to the FBI. And that's why they would never bust him. But it's the same in every city. It's the same in every crime region. And that's the way it's always worked. There's a reason that when Prohibition was overthrown after a decade in the early 30s, that they then made drugs illegal. You could buy cocaine, heroin, opium, whatever you wanted at the corner drugstore. And you go to the statistics, there was much less drug use, and of course a lot less drug overdose, because it was really seen as a disease and pathetic and something bad. But by making it illegal, now the criminals get it, now they got fancy cars, now it's seen as cutting edge and rebellious, and Hollywood pushed that image, of course, so that young people would use the drugs. Also, the big mega banks and the crime syndicates and their minions, they talk about Whitey Bulger being a big heavy hitter. They talk about people like Whitey Bulger being the boss. Always the gutter level so-called bosses are really just the lower compartment of the criminal system. But we're told that's as high as it goes, when in truth, it's the mega banks, then the FBI, CIA under them, then controlling the different organized crime syndicates, who they then use the low-level criminals who we're told at the top to go after the competition. But we'll break it all down when we come back.
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number 3. In some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now, new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number 4. Dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number 5. A solar power generator provides powerful backup, insurance, and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
The folks at eFoods Direct have saved you from the huge price increases on food by buying raw materials ahead and packing your supplies themselves. They haven't increased their prices on great long-term food reserves since last year. With the rising cost of raw materials and gas prices, they can't hold off any longer. As of July 1st, eFoods Direct is forced to increase their prices so they can still ship you the best storable food on the planet. Until the end of June, you can lock in the cost of your food at last year's prices by calling 800-409-5633. Your time is running out to build your supply with the best food on the planet at last year's prices with eFoods Direct. Call 800-409-5633. Prices go up at the end of June. Go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex.
We all know that Berkey Water Purification Systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 6 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey Guy offers amazing specials for Berkey Water Filtration Systems. The Berkey Light Systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey Light System today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $231, and the Berkey Guy will ship your order free of charge. With the purchase of a Berkey Light, the Berkey Guy is also offering a set of fluoride and arsenic filters for only $39.99. That's over 30% off the retail price. Call the Berkey Guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at GoBerkey.com. That's GoBerkey.com today.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCM Radio Network.
I know why a lot of people don't like to face corruption, because it's scary. It's disgusting, and it'll freak you out to realize that you're in a very corrupt society. But if we do realize this, if we do face up to this, we can save our republic. Before I get back into the ATF caught running a false flag against the Second Amendment, key report at Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. And in case you think our evidence doesn't point at that, you should go read the article. Or even Investors Business Daily, very prestigious. Was Fast and Furious a gun control plot? Of course it is. You know, Fox News is saying how the ATF screwed up and helped ship the guns in. They've been caught lying to Congress. They did this from the time Obama got in. His strategy to repass the assault weapons ban and shut down gun shows, including fake stings here in Austin, was to shut down the Second Amendment via the crisis in Mexico. Okay? But I'm digressing. Or not even digressing. That's what I want to get to later. Remember, you can pull this up. Like I've dug this up before. I want to dig it up again. We've got it in some documentary from CBS in the 80s about La Cosa Nostra and the Mafia. But I know we've got the clip and played it years ago. But it's just like I can't find the clip of Rick Perry on my show. It's from 4 years ago. We got to archive stuff or figure out some system to do that with really cool stuff. But it was the head of the FBI, J. Edgar Hoover, saying that La Cosa Nostra, organized crime, period, did not exist. Now, he was saying this decades after people knew that there were gangs and organized crime. But he was saying they were unorganized because they were blackmailing him. But more than just blackmailing J. Edgar Hoover, the FBI, from its inception, was only there to shut down their competition. They didn't go after Joseph Kennedy. the biggest bootlegger on the East Coast. They didn't go after the mafia in Chicago. They didn't go after any of those groups. They only went after later Italian mafia because they got too big for their britches. And they still didn't want to get them for anything. It's kind of like Ken Starr going after Clinton for lying about having sex with Monica Lewinsky. They don't want to go after him for missile secrets or corruption or payoffs because that was connected to the Republican leadership. That's why they used the IRS to go after Al Capone, something that wasn't connected to everything else and all the other syndicates. So it's basically using government to knock off their competition instead of just shooting them with a Tommy gun. But when the government wants to kill you, they hire mafia to do it in many cases. And that's why there were some mafia hitmen, snipers on record, in and around with the JFK killing. And they had some other backups, and they had E. Howard Hunt, deathbed confession, you know, also there in the background. And the CIA, when it was OSS in World War II, had used mafia in Europe as ways to get intelligence on the Nazis. The Nazis did the same thing. So these relationships have always been there, and you're naive if you say that they aren't. But the whole thing with Whitey Bulger is this. Here's a guy where, in the fine print, it's confirmed he was protected by the FBI and paying high-level FBI off for decade after decade after decade. And finally, the state police got tired of it, started an investigation, and that forced the feds to come in. And then Bulger was allowed to basically flee. But for whatever reason now, decades later, the protection has been decided to be removed from Bulger. So they run a PR campaign. Where is Bulger? Where is Bulger? And then magically, days after the campaign, they go and bust him. They knew where he was the entire time. He was basically in an unofficial witness protection program. And now why are they going to burn Bulger is the question. Has he have the people he can blackmail died? Has there been an inside deal where they stole his Swiss money? I don't know. But the whole thing is as phony as a $3 bill. And people need to grow up and realize how corrupt this government is. Now, when we come back, I'm going to get into the ATF mafia. Stay with us.
This is GCN, the Genesis Communications Radio Network.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones, and I want to tell you about the Silver Lungs Generator. Now you can produce pure and endless colloidal silver and deliver the solution directly into the bloodstream by breathing the solution through the lungs. The respiratory system is the first line of defense for airborne pathogens and viruses. The Silver Lungs Generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced nano-silver solutions and also delivers the silver nanoparticles instantly into the bloodstream. With continued legislation threatening the sale of nano-silver products, you can now produce pure and endless colloidal silver with the Silver Lungs Generator. Very easy to follow, step-by-step instructions are provided, making production fast and simple. Go to www.silverlungs.com today and learn more about the breakthrough technology of the Silver Lungs Generator. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCM Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Okay, I'm here looking over all the news during the break and realizing the fact that I'm not covering enough information. So I'm going to finish up with the ATF mafia. And then I'm going to get into all the financial news and what's happening globally, because the dominoes are falling through Europe and coming towards England and then the United States doorstep. And everything that's being done to Greece has already been done here to one extent, but it's only going to get deeper by degree. And there's also this article from yesterday, big key report from Paul Joseph Watson that I could just kick myself for not covering. I read this yesterday morning about 6 a.m. when Watson published it. And along with it is actually the actual study. Did we ever print the actual study? I just want to show folks that. Or maybe if we go to Watson's article after the break, we can click on the study and show it to folks via prisonplanet.tv. New study finds direct link between vaccines and infant mortality, and it is a prestigious study. So we're going to be going over that today. I also have a member of the EU.